in this circuit because of the feedback from the output to the inverting terminal. The op-amp will operate as a voltage buffer with a unity gain, and it will be responsible for driving the transistor Q1 and Q2. For VI greater than 0, transistor Q2, which is a PNP transistor, will remain off, and Q1 operates as an emitter follower amplifier, and it pushes the current from the emitter to the load. Remember that the emitter follower amplifier has a voltage gain of 1 or less, but here the power amplifier goal is to provide a high current boost. For VI smaller than 0, Q1, which is an NPN transistor, will remain off, and Q2 operates as an emitter follower, and it pulls the current from the load to the emitter. To calculate the maximum power efficiency, first we need to determine the maximum peak voltage and current provided by the supplies. The maximum peak voltage across the load is the power supply voltage minus the transistor collector emitter saturation voltage. This is the peak voltage due to positive input, and we have a similar value for the negative inputs. The maximum current flowing through the load will be the maximum peak voltage divided by the load resistance. Now, if we divide the peak current by pi, we will get the average current flowing through each transistor and also the load. Therefore, the total average current drawn from the power supply by the transistor Q1 and Q2 will be twice of an individual current. Here in this example, we assume that the collector current equals the emitter current. The maximum power provided by the sources can be determined by multiplying the average current by the voltage source. The average AC output power can be calculated by multiplying the peak voltage by the peak current at the load and divided by 2. If you recall, this formula comes from the circuit analysis. And the maximum power efficiency is the ratio of consumed power by the 16 ohm load to the power provided by the supply. The push-pull efficiency is not 100% because some of the power provided by the supply is dissipated in the transistors. Here, to find the power dissipated in each transistor, we can subtract the power consumed by the load from the power provided by the supply and divide it by 2, because we have 2 transistors. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Now back to the video. The resistor RB limits the current drawn by the transistor from the op-amp output. But we need to size it in such a way which it can provide the base current necessary for the 16 ohm load at the emitter. Because here the op-amp is acting as a buffer, then the voltage across the resistor RB is the base emitter voltage. So the base current is the base emitter voltage divided by RAB. The emitter current of the transistor, which here is the load current, is related to the base current by a factor of beta plus 1. And also, we already know that the load current can be determined by subtracting the collector emitter saturation voltage from the supply and divided by the load resistance. So, by rewriting this equation for finding RB, we can determine the maximum value for the base resistor. I have other videos in reviewing op-amp and BJT circuits, which I will put the links under the video description.